I think a lot of it was the media. I think Jerry was found guilty before he ever went to trial.
Dottie Sandusky is unwavering in her belief. She says her husband, former Penn State assistant coach Jerry Sandusky, is innocent and did not receive a fair trial.
I've known him for 38 years. I've been married to him for 37, and he's always been truthful to me. And I've asked him, and we've talked about it, and the stories are just, I cannot believe the stories that have been told about him.
Was there a family discussion where Jerry came to you all and said, I did not do this. I did not do these things that I'm being accused of.
Yes, we kept it from the kids as long as we could because we did not know what was going to happen. And that was really hard. We had to tell the kids, and the kids questioned their dad, and he talked to them and he told them, and they believed their dad.
At any point, did you have any doubt at all? Did you say to yourself, I've known this man, you know, practically my whole life, but is there a chance?
I don't know, because I know who he is. I know who he is. And I know that he is not guilty.
Sandusky is not alone in her belief.
This is not a situation where Dottie is simply standing by her man and has no knowledge of the accusations.
Family confidant and documentary filmmaker John Ziegler also believes in Sandusky's innocence. He takes issue with Penn State administrators who he says railroaded former head football coach Joe Paterno by firing him in the wake of the scandal.
When Joe Paterno is fired, it is a nuclear explosion that goes through the landscape of this case. And because of that, Jerry Sandusky loses all presumption of innocence.
Back in 1998, Penn State police launched an investigation after a young boy's mother reported Sandusky had showered with her son on campus. No charges were filed, but a police report shows an officer advised Sandusky not to shower with any child. Sandusky stated he wouldn't. So, why did he keep showering with young boys?
Would it have been smart to do it again?
And I have said that to Jerry as well. And I don't know if Dottie is, but I know that this is something that Jerry regrets.
But told, not a good idea to do it again, and then he does it again.
But it was like, it wasn't like he just took boys and took them to the shower. It was when he would work them out, and they would shower, and it's a public place. I mean, there's people that come and go.
The one thing that I heard from people in this community repeatedly, she's just deluding herself or has buried things just so deeply, she's just unwilling to accept the truth.
I'm not that kind of a person, and I believe he's innocent. And if I didn't believe he was innocent, I would not stand by him.
We first met Dottie Sandusky during a visit to the state prison in Greene County, Pennsylvania, where her 70-year-old husband is serving a 30 to 60-year sentence.
He's in his cell 23 hours a day, Monday through Friday, and then on weekends it's 24 hours. It's hard. We talk about what he's doing in prison. What has happened, you know? And I tried to cheer him up, but usually he cheers me up instead of me cheering him up.
When we were at prison, I remember something that you had brought up, which was very telling to me. You referenced victim number 9, and you became very angry because that was the one, I believe, who had said when he was in the basement, he called out for help, and you should have heard. You said, I was here. And if someone hit you, I would have said something. I'm paraphrasing.
He said he screamed. He said he screamed. He also said we didn't feed him. If we did, we brought his food down to the basement, which is untrue. I can take you down to the basement.
So it's one flight down here.
Right.
So is this the room where most of the
right where the accused, where the victim number 9 said that he screamed
from this room here?
Mm-hmm.
The young man, known only as victim number 9 during the trial, testified Sandusky raped him in the basement bedroom, and he screamed for help.
So if someone had screamed, you're saying it would have
I would have heard it. Mm-hmm.
Since the trial, 26 young men have come forward and settled claims with Penn State, totaling nearly $60 million, all saying they were abused by Sandusky as boys.
In the face of all of that, why do you still believe?
Because he is innocent.
Why do you think so many would say the same thing about Jerry Sandusky?
I think that they could have been manipulated by people. I think a lot of them had financial problems. I don't believe their stories.
Nor does she believe the couple's youngest adopted son, Matt, who told police he too had been abused after previously telling a grand jury his father had not molested him. He settled with Penn State for an undisclosed amount. Jerry Sandusky responded in writing about the allegations.
This is from February 3rd. It's a letter from Jerry. I've been consumed with how or if to respond to Matt. I wrote, I rewrote, and rewrote. It ended with four pages of writing that just sit. It's very confusing. Is that the same for you? Is it confusing for you?
I don't know whether someone talked to him, whether he saw money. You would have to ask Matt. I don't know.
Would you want to reconcile with Matt?
I would like to talk to Matt. I really miss seeing his kids. They were part of our lives. And the hurt that they must be going through. I would love to talk to Matt just to see, you know, why and what his thoughts are.
Sandusky lost his most recent appeal, but will not give up trying to prove his innocence, writing in another letter, "My biggest hope at the moment is that somehow people will realize how unfair everything was and that judges will have the courage to examine everything."
I believe in God, and I believe God has a purpose, and some purpose will come out of this, that he will see us through.